I must say that I am most ashamed of the way that we treat each other as supposed human beings. And my heart literally broke when I saw this video of the young Talent Fambuane Black, the taxi driver slain by NDF soldiers during a recent Operation Kalahari operation, being returned home. And this was with government assistance. Friend of the family spoke to Today on One's Less Than Waller about this.
The process was so much difficult because by the time when the guy gone and we tried to run around to put the man together, and it was difficult, as I said. And the other thing is, like, we were expecting the government of Namibia to do something for the for example transport and to give something for us so that we can manage to take him back home. But unfortunately our embassy, Zimbabwean embassy, they try to stop us to say no. We try to communicate with the government of Namibia, so try to just wait a little bit of 2-3 days while we were waiting, and the body was supposed to departure by Tuesday or Wednesday last week. Unfortunately the body didn't manage to departure because of we were waiting for the government of Namibia and the embassy of Zimbabwe, but they couldn't manage to do anything until when we take the plan B of taking through over those buses, this transporting people to Zim. But anyway, everything goes well. The guy managed to try to arrive in Zim last night. By 2 o'clock, he was already in Zim. So I hope by today, the burial, it went well in Zim. According to those people of the one who prepared the body, they have some conditions they do. They managed to embalm him so that he can manage to drive all the way. The time when he reaches him, everything it will be possible, everything it will be fine. So I hope even the guy whom I was communicated with him in Zim, he said they travel well, they reach there well. It was difficult. Even me, I was supposed also to go to Zim, but due to the money problems, due to the economy problems, you know, even in Zim, things is tough now. I was supposed to go also, but due to the money problem, I didn't manage to go. We managed to send only the brother and other colleagues, only maybe two of them, because the man which you spend on empowerment and all those things and the transportation is almost 30,000 which we spent. So for other people to go, it was tough because of the money. But you know, as a foreigner, what you know, in a foreign land, sometimes it's a bit difficult to come up with such as those things, you know. But unfortunately about this funeral, as I said before, we manage as Zimbabweans who are here, as a Zimbabwean community, we sit down, we call each other, we come together, we manage to do something for Charlie so that he can manage to go back home. But it's tough, as you know, in a foreign land. It's very, very tough. Even the guy was also trying to get bread here and there, you know, it was not that much fine for him, so that we can say no. The guy was having something, the guy was just struggling also to put food on the table. It was tough for him, and he was the breadwinner, it is family. Now it's tough for the parents who are there, for the parents which are left there. No one can help them.